celebrated on 4th October every year to raise awareness about improving the welfare standards of the animals around the world. The first World Animal Day took place on 24th March 1925 in the Sport Palace in Berlin, Germany. It was founded by writer and animal activist Heinrich Zimmermann. Earth is currently experiencing a biodiversity crisis. Recent estimates suggest that extinction threatens up to a million species of plants and animals, in large part because of human activities such as habitat loss, deforestation, hunting, and overfishing. Other serious threats include changes in land use, such as expanding urban areas and devoting more land to agriculture or livestock, the spread of invasive species and diseases from human trade, as well as poaching, overfishing, and climate change. In many cases, these changes are working in tandem to destroy animal and insect habitats or force species to migrate to other regions where they may be ill-suited to survive. Today, extinctions are occurring hundreds of times faster than they would naturally. Climate change presents a long-term threat. Humans' burning of fossil fuels has let us chemically imitate large indigenous provinces through the injection of billions of tons of carbon dioxide and other gases into the Earth's atmosphere every year. The Siberian traps released more than 1,400 times the carbon dioxide than humans released in 2018 from burning fossil fuels for energy. However, humans are emitting greenhouse gases as fast as or even faster than the Siberian traps, and the Earth's climate is rapidly changing as a result. Herbivorous, animals that only eat plants. Carnivorous, animals that only eat other animals. Omnivorous, animals that eat plants and animals. The final part of the food chain is the decomposers, which feed on decaying matter. When one of the links in a food chain is no longer present, the food chain breaks and the species go extinct. If one species in the food web ceases to exist, one or more members in the rest of the chain would cease to exist too. A plant or an animal doesn't even have to become extinct to affect one of its predators. The hairless suckerfish, for example, used to eat snails in the 19th century. After which, topsoil and other debris invaded rivers where the fish lived, the snake population dwindled. The U.S. Geological Survey notes this decline probably caused the fish to go extinct. Overfishing occurs when people take too much food from the oceans and the species can't replace themselves. Atlantic cod almost became extinct in the 1900s when fishermen removed too many of those fish from the sea. Interrelationships within a food web can be so intricate that a chain of disruptive events can occur when one ecosystem component changes. Polar bears, for example, rely on seals for food. The seal population may decline if Arctic cod, a key food supply for seals, dwindles. Cod eat zooplankton and zooplankton eat ice algae. If climate changes cause sea ice to melt, the ice algae population drops, creating a cascading effect that reduces the polar bear population. Today, the loss of species is estimated to be between 1,000 to 10,000 times than that of the natural extinction rate. World Wildlife Foundation reports between 0.01% to 0.1% of all species go extinct every year. Considering the fact that there are around 2 million species on the planet, it means between 200 to 2000 extinctions occur every year. And note, we are talking about species of which humans are one. As per 2018 reports of WWF, there is a 60% decline in the population of mammals, birds, fish, reptiles, amphibians in just 40 years. As per the IUCN Red List, more than 30,000 species are threatened with extinction, which means 27% of the nearly 112,000 species accessed so far are under grave danger. As per the latest report, 7 animals that are on the verge of extinction include pangolin, rhinoceros, tiger, vicuna, Sumatran elephant and orangutan. The Millennium Ecosystem Assessment, which involved more than 1,000 experts, estimated an extinction rate that was later calculated at up to 8,700 species a year or 24 a day. More recently, scientists at the UN Convention on Biological Diversity concluded that every day up to 150 species are lost. That could be as much as 10% a decade. Things we should all do to protect endangered species. 1. Educate your family about endangered species in your area. It's not just about snow leopards in Russia. It's about the ecosystem in your own backyard. From the worms in the garden to the bats that pollinate and control the mosquitoes, there are many ways that our daily habits at home affect these creatures. 2. Recycle and buy sustainable products. Never buy furniture made of wood from rainforest or endangered trees. Recycle your cell phones, because a mineral used in electronic production is mined in gorilla habitat. Don't use palm oil, because forests where tigers live are being cut down to plant palm plantations. 3. Grow native plants. It's not a brainer, but local species rely on local plants. Attracting native insects like bees and butterflies can help pollinate your flowers. And conversely, invasive species compete with native species for resources and habitat, threatening biodiversity. They can even prey on native species directly, forcing native species towards extinction. 4. Reduce your water consumption. Clean water is a global problem for wild animals. Now I dump chemicals or pharmaceuticals down toilets, storm drains or into streams or lakes. 5. Reduce your personal footprint. Drive less, walk more, support better public transport, use biodegradable products and eat whole food from your farmer's market. Do not buy plastic products. Take your bags to the store, reuse containers and properly dispose of lightweight plastics. Wild animals get tangled in these products and they end up in the ocean being ingested by small fish and killing off beneficial microorganisms. 6. Do not purchase products from companies that are known polluters. 7. Herbicides and pesticides are hazardous pollutants that affect wildlife at many levels. These chemicals take a long time to degrade and build up in the soils before disseminating throughout the food chain. Critical predators like hawks, owls and coyotes suffer if they eat poisoned animals, and it can drop the whole populations. Thanks for watching. Please share this video among your groups and help preserve the wildlife.